From this lecture onwards, we will discuss the module 3 topics. And in module 3, mainly we'll discuss the combinational circuits in digital electronics. And these are the main topics that are included in the module 3. Okay, in module 3, we'll discuss the combinational logic system, okay, mainly the comparator, multiplexer, demultiplexer, encoder, and decoder. And it's also, we'll discuss in this particular module, that is the arithmetic circuit. Okay, first we'll discuss half adder, then full adder circuit, subtractor and full subtractor, serial and parallel adders, and one more adder is known as a BCD adder. And brief idea about BCD adder already we discussed in module 1. And the last stage is again the modeling and simulation of combination circuits using Verilog code. And in first lecture, the first topics we are going to discuss is about the arithmetic circuits, okay, half adder. The first topic is half adder. Then we will discuss different cases of half adder and the circuit. And then we will discuss the full adder circuit and how we can implement full adder using half adder. Okay, these are the different topics that we included in the lecture 1 in module 3. So before starting the arithmetic circuit, I'll just give you an idea about what I mean by combination circuit. Okay, so combination circuit we can consider as it is a logical gate, a circuit which contains logic gates, and there will be inputs, okay, and there will be one or more output. Okay, that's a simple gate circuit, can be considered as a combinational circuit. But when you discuss combination circuit, we will also mention other circuit which is known as a sequential circuit. But at present we are not discussing sequential circuit. But when you discuss the sequential circuit, we will discuss some more concepts. This is known as memory, timing, and feedback. But in the case of combination circuit, there is no memory circuit, no memory element, no timing circuit, no feedback element. Okay. Combination circuit means simply a logic gates connection. There will be 2-3 inputs or more than that, and there will be one or more output. Okay, and we'll see different examples of combination circuits also. In combination circuits, when we want to design a combination circuit, first these are the three steps that we follow in designing of a combination circuit. So first we need to write the truth table of that particular circuit, okay, or particular question. And after that, from that particular truth table, we need to write the Boolean expression, okay, either by simplifying by using K-map or by Boolean simplification, K-map or by Boolean simplification, a simplification method. We need to derive some Boolean expression for that particular function. After that, by using gates, we need to implement the particular circuit. This is a normal procedure for the implementation of combinational circuit. Now we'll move to the first topic, that is a half adder. Half adder means in module 1 already we discussed what you mean by binary addition. Already we discussed what you mean by binary addition, and the circuit which used to perform the binary addition we can call it as a half adder. Okay, it's in a combinational circuit, and also we can call it as an arithmetic circuit, because binary addition means it's a arithmetic operation. And very specifically, what do you mean by half adder means half adder accept 2 binary digits, okay, and we'll call it as inputs, and produce 2 binary digits as the output. We'll call that output as sum and carry bit. So the 2 binary digits as the input and 2 binary digits as the output. So 2 inputs and 2 outputs. That's a basic structure of a half adder. And this is a basic structure of a half adder. So here you can provide inputs. In this particular case, A and B are the inputs. And here the sigma symbol, or you can write S also. In most of the textbooks, we will use the notation S or this letter sigma. Or you can write sum also. So sum and carry will be the output. And this carry is normally indicated as C out. Okay. C out and S. Okay. And we'll discuss the operation of half order. And here you can see, consider two inputs A and B. And if you add two inputs A and B, and if the values of A and B are 0, 0, we have two binary bits, 0 and 0, you will get 0 as sum and carry is equal to 0. So 0 plus 0. And these are the outputs. Similarly, we'll consider the other combination, the two bits. It can be 0, 1 also. If it is 0, 1, the sum will be 1 and carry will be 0. And this is another combination. A can be 1 and B is equal to 0. So 1 plus 0. Okay. If you add 1 plus 0, again sum is equal to 1 and carry is equal to 0. And finally, the other last combination is both inputs are 1, 1. So this 1, 1, 1 and 1 are represented in binary. So 1 plus 1 is not equal to 2. It's actually 1, 0. Okay. So sum part will indicate as 0 and carry is equal to 1. So this is a simple binary addition rule that we already discussed in module 1. And now we can convert. So, or we can say that a circuit which performs this particular operation is known as a half order. Okay. In a simple sense, a circuit, a logical circuit, or an arithmetic circuit, or a combination circuit which perform this particular operation, it will accept two inputs and it will produce two output in this particular manner. It can be considered as a half order. So now we need to implement the half order circuit. So the normal procedure to implement any combination circuit, first we need to write the truth table. Okay. So addition of two 1-bit number that we need to perform. And this is a black box. We can consider as a half order circuit. There will be two inputs A and B and two outputs, sum and carry. Okay. And first we'll write the truth table. So already we got the different input combination and corresponding output from the previous slide. And here you can see that A and B are the inputs. So A and B can be considered as the input. And this section we can consider as the output. Sum and carry. Okay. And if you use two bits, you will get four different combinations. If it is 0, 0, sum will be 0 and carry 0. From the previous explanation, 0, 1, sum will be 1, carry 0. 1, 0. Sum will be 1, carry 0. And the last case, 1, 1, sum is equal to 0 and carry 1. And now we need to design a circuit for the sum and carry. We need to implement a logical circuit to perform the sum and carry. Okay. In order to implement the sum and carry, we can use a K-map. Okay. It's not necessary that we need to use a K-map, but I will tell you how we can use K-map for this. So first we need to discuss how we can implement sum. So sum we can implement as a function of A and B, the two variables A and B. And if you consider this, sum is equal to 1 only for 0, 1, 2, 3. For inputs 1 and 2, the output is equal to 1. For all other value, for 0, 1, here it's 0, 1. So 0, 0, the output is 0. For 0, 1, output is 1. And 1, 0, output is 1. And for 1, 1, the output is equal to 0. So we got two 1s here. So we cannot make any other group. We need to consider as a single group, single 1. So this, I can write A, B bar. Okay. And the top, I can write, it becomes A bar B. So sum can be written as A, B bar plus A bar B, so which is equal to the XOR operation. So we can write which is equal to A XOR B. So sum can be implemented by using an XOR gate, A XOR B. So these two inputs must be connected to the XOR gate, and output of the XOR gate is connected to the sum. So sum will be A XOR B. Now we can discuss about what do you mean by this carry. So carry will be another output. So here it is 0, 1, 0, and 1. Okay. Now, if you consider the carry as a function of A and B, carry as a function of variable A and B. So if it is 0, 0 from the table, the value is equal to 0. For 0, 1, again it's 0. For 1, 0, it's 0. For only for 1, 1, it's equal to 1. So we can group this one. So finally, I can write AB. So this is an AND operation. So by performing an AND operation, you will get the half order carry, the output value. So I can replace this box or the half order module by using this particular circuit, sum AX or B and carry AB, or I can say that this will be the output. So sum you can calculate by XOR gate and carry by using the AND gate. So this is the logical circuit which used to perform the half order. Okay. I think it's clear. Now we can move on to the next topic, that is a full order. So in the previous case, we consider that we will add 2 bits at a time, but in the case of full order, we will add 3 bits at a time. Okay. So in full order, accept 2 input bits. Okay. That is a 2 input bits and an input carry also. We'll discuss what you mean by this input carry, or you can, other words, we can say 3 bits, 3 input bits, and generate 2 output bits, 1 sum and 1 output carry. Okay. And we'll see the block diagram of that particular full adder. Here you can see that 2 inputs A, B, and the input carry is indicated as Cin, or you can consider the third input is C or Cin. And this is the sum output and the carry. So carry I can, sum I can indicate as S, carry as C out. Now we'll consider one case when there is 3 inputs. Okay, when you want to add 3 inputs, or I can say a simple example like this. So when you want to add like this, 101. So for example, 001. Okay, it's a 3-bit addition at a time. So if you add the first 2 bits, okay, in this particular example, here you will get required only half order, 1 plus 1, you will get 0 here, and there will be carry. So when you add the second case, second stage addition, here you can see that you need to add 3 bits, like 1 plus 0 plus 0, 1 plus 0 plus 0. So in this particular case, you need to add 3 bits at a time. So we need an adder circuit which can add a 3-bit at a time. So A, B, and C. So here this value is indicated as C. So in simple sense, we can consider there will be 3 inputs. Okay. The 3 inputs are indicated here. 0, 0, 0. This is one combination, 0, 0, 0. Okay. And output will be sum is equal to 0 and carry is equal to 0. In another case, 0, 0, 1. When it is 0, 0, 1, if you add these 3 bits, sum is equal to 1 and carry is equal to 0. 0, 1, 0. Okay, sum is equal to 1 and carry is equal to 0. 0, 1, 1 means first we need to add 0 plus 1, you will get 1. After that, again, you need to add 1 plus 1. Okay, if you add the first 2 values, you will get 1. Again, you need to add 1. So you will get 1, 0. So sum will be 0 and carry will be 1. And here only 1 plus 0 plus 0, so you'll get 1 and 0, and 1 plus 0 plus 1, again you will get 1 0. Here also you'll get 1 0, and finally when you add 1 plus 1 plus 1, so if you add the first 2 ones, you'll get 1 0. Again you need to add plus 1, so it becomes 1 and 1. So sum is equal to 1, carry is equal to 1. That's why there is 2 1. So this is a full adder operation, or we need to implement a circuit which perform this particular operation. Okay. So first we need to write the truth table from this particular explanation. So we can consider the 3 input truth table. So I can consider the 3 values can be considered as an input. So okay, either you can call it as C or C in. Okay. And the output can be C out and the sum. Okay, we can use a different notation. For the simplicity, we'll use A, B, C, and here it'll C or C out, etc. And from the previous explanation, I can fill this particular table, truth table. And now we need to implement this particular function. So if you take this particular function, if there is 3 variables, you will get 8 different combinations. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So if you consider the sum output, so these two columns indicate the output. Okay, so first we can consider sum. If you consider sum, sum will be 1 when the input is 1, okay, 2, 4 and 7. So I can write like this, this particular sum is equal to 1 when this value A bar, B bar, C. So this will be one min term, and for the second case the min term will be A bar, B and C bar. And for this particular case, it is A, B bar and C bar. And for the last case, it's A, B, C. So in a similar way, I can write the sum equation. So we can see all the terms are here, only 4 terms. So A bar B bar C plus A bar B C plus. So I can write SOP form. And in SOP form, either you can write in variable form or by using this numbers. So here you can see the function output is equal to 1 when is 1, 2, 4 and 7. So I can write like this. Sum is equal to sigma 1, 2, 4, 7. This is the SOP form. Okay, SOP representation. Similar way, I can write the POS form representation also. When will be the function value will be 0. Okay. For that, I need to write 0, 3, 5, and 6. So this is another representation of this full adder. And for the carry or carry out, I can write the other cases. So this particular column I can consider and you can verify the values. Okay. And it is written here. And in SOP form, this is the SOP form. You can see that the sum already we considered. Now we need to see out. See out is equal to 1 when input is 3, 5, 6, and 7. Okay. So you can write 3, 5, 6, 7. Or in POS form, I can write the carry out is equal to 5, M, the other values. Here it is written 3, 5, 6, 7. So other values I can write, then it will be 0. Okay. This one. This one, okay. You can write 0, 1, 2, and 4. Either you can write in SOP form or in POS form. This is one method, but normally we will use another method, that is a K-map for simplification of true table. So first we can implement the sum. So for the sum, you can see this is 0, this is 1. It's a 3 variable K-map. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Now we can see that it's a 1, 2, 4, 7. So it is indicated 1, okay, 2, 4 and 7. So this is a K-map. And if you write the equation for this, for the group, here it is A and here it is B bar C bar. Okay, if you write the equation for this particular group, it becomes A bar B bar C. And for the last this particular group, I can write A bar B C bar. And for this particular value, I can write A B C. So we'll get 4, exactly the same thing written in the SOP form. Okay. And now we need to simplify this. And on the simplification part, you can see that you need to group this value. So if you group here, you can see that you can group A bar. So A bar is here. So remaining term, that is if you group A bar, the first two term, if you consider, it becomes B bar C plus B C bar. So which we can return as A bar is like a XOR operation. So, okay, B bar and B and C bar. So I can replace this by B X or C. So it is written here B X or C. And if you consider the last two terms, I can take A common. Okay, this is one operation. If you consider the last two terms, I can write A B C plus B bar C bar. So this is something similar to XNOR operation. B bar and C bar. So I can replace this by A B XOR C the whole bar. That is a XNOR operation. So here you can see the XNOR operation. Now again, if you look at here, so here it is A. Now it is here. It is A bar. Here it is A. Here it is B plus B XOR C. Here it is B XOR C the whole bar. So again, we can see an XOR operation. So I can combine its A XOR B XOR C. So the sum I can represent by the XOR operation A XOR B XOR C. Now we'll move over to carry part. So this is a carry portion. So if you write the carry portion, here you can see that this is one group. Here also you can verify this 3, 5, 6, 7. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So I need to indicate 3, 5, 6, 7. So 3, 5, 6, and 7. So I can make this one group. Okay. If you write this particular group by grouping 3 and 7, I can write BC. And if you group 7 and 6, okay. 7 and 6, if you group, you can write A in row wise and column wise, it's B. And if you group 5 and 7, okay, if you group 5 and 7, you can write A and C. So we'll get three terms. Okay, exactly the same thing. You can write like this, okay. After simplification of this particular Boolean expression or from the came up, you can write a BC AC plus AB. So you got the final equation, Boolean expression. Now we need to implement this. So for implementing some operation, I need an XOR gate. Okay, I need an XOR gate, and the input of the XOR gate, there will be three inputs, A, B, C. So this will be the sum. Okay, A XOR B XOR C. And now we need to design this a carry part. For implementing the carry part, we need again an SOP operation. For that, there will be an OR gate. Okay. The input of the OR gate will be three AND gates. Because we need AB plus AC plus BC. So there will be A input, B input, and another one A input and C input, and another input B and C. So this is a logical diagram for sum and carry of a full order. Now we'll move to the next portion. This is very important, and most of the exams you need to. They will ask this particular question, how we can implement full order with two half order and an OR gate. So this can also be asked by implementing two half order also. Okay, so this is a half order, sorry, full order. If you consider any full order circuit, there will be three inputs and two outputs. But if you take any half order circuit, there will be only two inputs. Okay, so this is the input portion. So this will be the input, only two inputs and same output, sum and carry. So this is a logical circuit for that. So sum I can express by A X or B and carry by A B. Okay. Now we can move to the explanation part, how we can reduce the concept to implement full adder by using half adder. So when you get a 3-bit at a time, so for example, I can take here 110. You can take this particular case. When there's a question to add 1 plus 0, first one idea behind this, instead of adding 3 bit at a time, I can add 2 bit at a time. So I can first add these two ones. So 1 plus 1, you will get 1 plus 1 I can perform. So answer will be 0 and 1. So this will be the sum port. This will be the carry. Okay. And after getting this particular result, I can add the result and the next bit. So this will be the next bit. So I can take another bit here. So that is 0. Now I can add these two values. Again, 2 bits. So if you add 2 bits, it will be 0. Okay. And the sum part is okay. Okay, that is zero. So now we need to consider carry. So already there is a carry, so we can consider that carry. In another case, so we need some explanation. We got some logic to find the sum. So if you proceed like this, you will get the sum. That is exactly same. Okay, but we need to decide about the carry. What will be the final carry? Now we will consider another case. That is 0, 1, 1. Okay. If we take this particular example, first we need to consider 0 and 1. If you add 0 and 1, you'll get 1, and carry will be 0. Okay. Next, you need to add this 1 here. So we need to add like this. So this is a carry generator from the first addition. So now we are considering only 2-bit addition. So 2 ones. If you add 2 ones, you will get 0, and there will be carry. So this concept is also, I think, correct. 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Here also you can see that sum part is okay. Okay. And now we can see that in the first case, there is a carry when you add the first stage itself. Okay. So here the first stage carry. Here you can see that there is a carry in the second stage. Second stage addition. So in both cases, the output carry is equal to 1. So I can conclude that whenever there is a carry, either from the first stage or the second stage, we need to take this carry at the output side. So this is the idea behind implementing a half adder, sorry, implementing a full adder using half adder. Okay, instead of adding 3 bits at a time, we will add 2 bits at a time. Okay, now you can see that this is a half adder circuit. So there will be 2 inputs, A and B, and here you will get output A XOR B. It's a half adder, and the carry will be A B. The same thing. Okay, now we can consider one more half adder. So this is another half adder, and for this half adder, you can see that after adding, we'll get one result sum. That sum will be the input of the next stage. Okay, one input of the next stage. If you take a full adder, there will be another input, that is C in or C. So that C in or C will be the another input. Okay, C in or simply you can write C itself. Okay, if you write this A, B, C, first we will apply A and B, and you will get the result. So this is A and B. We will add A and B, so we'll get this is A XOR B, and this is C. Okay, this is a carry from the first stage that we can write A B. So carry of the first stage. Now, if you apply 2 inputs here, one is A XOR B, another one is C. If you apply 2 inputs A B, your output will be A XOR B. But in this particular case, one input is C, okay, C XOR, the other input is A XOR B. So you can write like this, A XOR B will be one input. Okay, this is one input and this is another input. So the final output will be A XOR B XOR C. Okay, A XOR B will be the one input, another input will be C. So you got the sum. Now we need to make an arrangement for the carry also. So in the first stage, carry is AB. Here the input, if the inputs are A and B, the output will be, output carry will be AB. Now in the second stage, the 2 inputs are A XOR B will be one input, another input is C. So you can write like this, the output of the second stage, A XOR B is one input, okay? Another input is C. So we need to perform the AND operation. So this is one input and this is another. So we need to perform AND operation. So we got individual carry here. So this is the second stage carry. What we call it as A XOR B into C. So if either AB or A XOR B into C is equal to 1, the output is equal to 1. So we need to connect an OR gate to perform. If any one of the input is 1, output should be 1. So we need to connect here 1 input. This is another input. So we need to add. So we need to connect to an OR gate, the AB output and AX or B into C output, the carry of the 2 stages. Okay. In circuit level also, you can do the same thing. So one input is AX or B. So this is AX or B. So the final output will be, so here another input will connect, that is C. Okay. So AX or B, there will be one input, another input is C. So we can write like this. XOR operation, and here the carry is AB, and here one input is C, another input is A XOR B. So we can write A XOR B into C. So we need to combine these two inputs to an OR gate to get the carry. So the final carry will be like this: AB plus A XOR B into C. Okay, so same thing you will get here. So this is the final circuit for so by using this so this is the final circuit which already we derived, and we can conclude that a full adder can be realized with two half adders and an OR gate. So this is a OR gate. So this is one half adder circuit. So this is another half adder circuit. So we need to study this particular, is very important circuit. You can expect this question in exams. Okay, it's a very important question. So full adder can be realized using two half adders. It's very important, two half adder and one OR gate. Okay, and finally I'll discuss one more question. You can work out this particular question. So don't get confused with the previous case. Here two half adders are cascaded, and here you can see that it behaves as an OR gate. We need to verify that. So the concept is different. In the previous case, we are not cascading two half adders. The connection is different. We are applying one more input, that is C. There is no C input in this particular case. There is only A and B. Output of half adder is A XOR B and A B in this particular case. And that input is connected to the, that output is connected to the input of the second half adder. Okay, this half adder one and this half adder two. And if you apply A XOR B and A B as the input, the output will be like this. One input is A XOR B, another one is XOR AB. Okay, and this is the carry output. This is the AND operation between the two inputs. So A XOR B will be the one input, and this is another input. Here also, this is one input, and this is another input. And so from the statement, we know that this is an OR operation, A XOR B. So now we can prove this by a simple Boolean algebra. So the sum you can write, already we got from the logical diagram, A XOR B XOR AB. Okay, we can expand this. So if there is two value X or Y, you can write XY, X bar Y plus XY bar. Okay, you need to write the complement here, here also the complement. So in this sense, if you consider this AB and A XOR B as the input, this is one input, this is another input. Okay. So here A bar B, here A B, here A XOR B, here XOR B the whole bar. And now by using De Morgan's theorem, the A B the whole bar, A B the whole bar can be written as A bar plus B bar. So it is written here. Okay. Now we can expand this particular expression. And here also this is XNOR operation. XNOR operation can be written as XY plus X bar Y bar. So based on that, you can expand this particular term. So now we can see that we can multiply this A B into A bar B bar. We can see that one is A and another one is A bar. So this term becomes zero, and another term is A B into A B. So finally, you will get A B itself. Okay, and here this A X or B can be expanded by XOR explanation. So here you can write XOR operation. Now we can multiply this A with A B bar and A bar B. So here it is A bar and here it is A. So A and A bar, it becomes zero. So this term becomes zero, but one term will be there, that is A bar B. Similarly, you can multiply B bar here also and here also. So here B bar and B, so final result will be zero here. So this term will be zero, and only term remaining is A B bar. Okay, now we can see the three terms, and if you take the three terms here, you can take A common in the first and last term. So if you take A common, so finally you can write B bar plus B. So B bar plus B is equal to one. So we can write A into A bar B. So by the rule, if A and A bar B, A, you can write simply a plus b. Okay, by redundant literal rule, you can write a plus a bar b is equal to a plus b. So we got this. And similar way, if you elaborate c, you will get zero. So you can expand this. So if you expand this, it becomes a bar b plus a b bar. And if you multiply with a b, okay, here a bar and a, so it becomes zero. Here it is b and b bar, so this term and this term becomes zero. So the final answer is zero. So when you cascade two half orders, the final answer is equal to an OR gate. Okay, that is different from the full order concept. Don't get confused. So that's why I given here. The two questions are different. So mainly you need to discuss about the previous one, how we can implement half order using, sorry, full order using two half order and OR gate. Here two half orders are cascaded. So two different circuits. Don't get confused. Okay.